Over the years, many companies have made and attempted handheld consoles. Some were good, some not so much. The only company I can think of that's consistently made good handheld consoles that were successful is Nintendo. Nintendo jumped into the portable game with the Game & Watch line, and a few years later introduced the Game Boy, which added cartridges, a standardized control scheme, and a monochrome LCD screen. The Game Boy Color added color into the mix and improved the formula further. Then in 2001, the Game Boy Advance was introduced, and that's what we're going to be looking at today. The Game Boy Advance added extra L and R buttons, and had more sound and graphical capabilities than its predecessors. The cartridges became a bit smaller too, but the best thing about the GBA is the fact that it's fully backwards compatible with Game Boy and Game Boy Color games, at least licensed ones. With a GBA, you can play almost 2 decades worth of games. In addition to that, some iconic NES and SNES games were remade for the system as well. That means I can play the first 2 NES Zelda games, Link to the Past, Link's Awakening, Oracles of Ages and Seasons, and Minish Cap all on the same system, not to mention 3 generations of Pokemon games. Now that the system has been superseded by 2 handheld consoles, or even 3 if you count the Switch, I think it's time for collectors to start picking up GBAs and its games. Prices are only going to go up as more and more people begin to categorize the Game Boy Advance as a retro console. Over the years, Nintendo made a bunch of devices capable of playing GBA games, some handheld, others not so. The original Game Boy Advance looks like this, quite a different form factor compared to the previous Game Boys. Personally, I really like the look of the system. It takes 2 AA batteries, which collectors will appreciate, but it still lacks backlighting. Thankfully, for those into modding their consoles, it is possible to add front lighting to those models. Only 2 years after the original Game Boy Advance, a new revision was unveiled called the Game Boy Advance SP. The form factor was changed into a clamshell design, and the cartridge now goes into the bottom rather than the top. Additionally, there's also a rechargeable battery instead of the usual AA dealio. I think the clamshell design is a great idea. Not only does it make the console easier to pocket, but it protects the screen from scratches and damage. Speaking of screen, the SP finally gave us what we wanted, a lit screen. What a glorious sight to behold. If you want to save a bit of battery life, you can even turn it off. As nice as the screen was, it still didn't feature a backlit screen. No, this is frontlit. Eventually, the SP was revised to feature a backlit screen, and just look at the difference. So much better. This time, Nintendo didn't give an option to turn the screen off at all. This particular iteration is called the AGS-101, named so after the model number on the back. Frontlit models are AGS-100. As you might imagine, most enthusiasts consider the 101 the ultimate Game Boy. If there's one thing I don't like about the SP, it has to be the lack of headphone jack. You need an adapter, which I don't have, that plugs into the second extension port in order to use headphones. And since that's where the charger connects, you can't charge and use headphones at the same time. And then over a decade later, Apple was all like, yep, that's a good idea, let's also remove our headphone jacks. But despite that, I would still recommend an AGS-101. Now, this device is a bit lesser known, and it's the Game Boy Advance Micro. It's tiny, but it looks really cool and sleek in my opinion. It doesn't feature backwards compatibility, which is too bad. So you can only play GBA games on this one. You can also change faceplates if you want a different look. I've always wanted one of these, but currently it looks like I'm priced out of the market. I checked eBay and it's very hard to find one under $100. And boxed examples go for $300 or $400 sometimes. An alternative to the Game Boy Advance SP is the original Nintendo DS and the DS Lite. Both feature backlit screens and Game Boy Advance support. The biggest problem is that Game Boy and Game Boy Color games can't be played on it, but still, compared to the SPs, the DSs are more plentiful, are cheaper, and have a frickin' normal headphone jack. I personally would recommend a DS Lite just because the screens are better than the original DS. If that wasn't enough, there's still one more device that can play GBA games, the Game Boy Player add-on for the GameCube. This is the best console add-on ever, in my opinion. It can play all Game Boy games, and you get to enjoy it on the big screen with stereo sound. And unlike the Super Game Boy, the games run at the correct speed. I already did a video on the Game Boy Player, so if you want to check it out, just click on the link on the top right of the video. The Game Boy Advance also has some interesting connectivity for its time. There was the GBA to GameCube adapter, which gave the Game Boy extra functionality with compatible GameCube games, and also the wireless adapter, which most people use to trade Pokemon with each other. And that's the Nintendo Game Boy Advance, one of my favorite consoles of all time. Hopefully you enjoyed this little overview. If you like what I do, consider checking out my Patreon page. I'm also doing more streaming lately. I've been streaming some Japanese games, but my goal is to stream a variety of different things. I just need a few more followers on Twitch, and I should be well on my way in becoming a Twitch affiliate. Thanks for watching, everyone, and see you again next time.